What did the bee use to comb his hair? A honeycomb. And this is Balloon Animal Lessons number 70. Hello, Balloon World. I'm Michael Floyd, your balloon twister, and today I want to show you how to make a balloon bee. This is a really cool design, and it only uses two balloons, and it's an introduction on how to use a white paint marker for the eyes. How cool is that? Let me show you how to do it. For this design, you'll need two balloons, a yellow 260 and a black 160. You can use a black 260. I just think a black 160 makes the wings look a lot nicer. Let's start with our black balloon. Get your black 160, and you want to inflate it about halfway. Let some air out and tie a knot. Give the balloon a nice stretch. We're gonna make two large flower petals. How large is up to you. Use whatever proportion size you think will look best. But for me, mine are gonna be about 6 inches tall. When I make the first one, I'm gonna take that knot and I'm gonna wrap it through to keep it from coming undone on me. Now I'm gonna make another one that same size. Oh, I didn't put enough air in it. That means I'm gonna have to cut the end and inflate it some more. Here's a really cool tip. Use a ribbon cutter to cut your balloons. That way you can get a nice, easy cut. And you don't have to use your mouth. Remember, your teeth are jewels, not tools. Now I can blow into it. And tie it again. The ribbon cutter I use is really cool because it can fit on your belt. So even when you need to cut or pop a balloon, I can just slide it right through. Okay, time for the second flower petal. I'm gonna fold it over, make another one the same size, twist off the section. Second flower petal, twist it together. Now I have some extra left over. So I can pop that with my hands, or I can give it a nice squeeze, and I can use that ribbon cutter. So I can go like this. There we go. Now to keep that from coming undone, I can tie that knot, or I can wrap it around and through a couple of times, and that'll work almost as good as a knot. And our wings are done! Now it's time for our body. Get your yellow 260 out, fold it in half. From that center point in the bottom, go up about an inch and pinch it there. You're gonna want to inflate it to about right there. Let a little air out and tie it. Make sure you give it a good stretch. We're gonna make a small flower petal for the head. It should be about as wide as it is long. To keep this from coming undone, I'm gonna take that knot, I'm gonna push it through the center. Because there's nothing worse than a balloon coming unraveled on you while you're trying to make it. Give the balloon a nice squeeze. I go about a hand's width down. If your hands aren't the same size as mine, that's gonna be about 3 or 4 inches. Then I'm gonna make two pinch twists. I make a 1-inch bubble. I fold it over. I pull it, pinch it, and twist it. One more. 1-inch bubble. Fold it over. Pull it, pinch it, twist it. Now I'm gonna make another section that same length. Give the balloon a squeeze. These two here should be about the same size. If they're not exactly the same size, that's okay. But they should be roughly the same size. Twist this section into this section. We want to give this balloon here a squeeze. Now we want to get our wings. Take your wings and put them here, right below this section. You're going to want to take this section over the wings and twist it into that two pinch twists right there, leaving just a little bubble at the end. Then you're gonna want to position it in between the two pinch twists, like so. This leaves the uninflated section here of the balloon for the stinger of our bee. And there we go, 1-2 balloon bee. Zzz. It's time for our face. To draw our face on our balloon, I'll be using a black Sharpie, but you can use any black marker. And I'm gonna be using a white Edding 750 paint marker, but you can use any paint marker. I'm gonna start with the white of the eyes. So I'm gonna shake up my paint marker, take it out. I'm gonna pump it once, get a little bit of paint on the end, and then I'm gonna draw the eyes. For the eyes, with a white paint marker, I draw two lines about halfway down the face. on either side of it. Then I make an arched semicircle on top of each of those lines. Then I fill in that semicircle. Now comes the hard part. We have to wait for the paint to dry before we use the black marker. And don't forget to put the cap back on the marker because we don't want it to dry out. Now that our paint is dry, on the bottom of each of our white semicircles, I'm gonna draw a line. Next, I'm gonna trace the rest of the semicircle, but I'm gonna leave the part in the middle of the face undone. Next, I'm gonna draw a vertical line from the bottom of the semicircle halfway up. Then I draw the mouth as an arch. Then in the corner of that mouth, I'm gonna do a smaller arch. Next, I'm gonna get my white marker back out and I'm just gonna touch a dot of it to the top right side of each of those black vertical lines. I think this really makes the character come alive. To make a black line on the back, what I like to do is take a black Sharpie and just go back and forth real quick, up and down the side. And I think that gives me a really cool characteristic stripe. And I usually give it 3 stripes. And we're finished with the artwork for our balloon bee. Another thing I sometimes like to do is I'll take the wings and adjust them so that they're up, giving the bee even more character. And we're done with our balloon bee. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And while you're down there, let me know what you want to learn next. If you enjoyed this video, tickle that thumbs up button. And if you want more balloon animal instructions, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I do balloon animal lessons on Mondays. I'm Michael Floyd, your balloon twister, reminding you that anything can be made out of balloons.